Hello there and welcome to Winrate Gaming with me, Martin Turner. Now today we're going to focus on the Butcher, a character from Diablo 3. I'm going to leave some of my gameplay of the Butcher in the background for you guys to watch whilst I explain my build and what I recommend to use. The Butcher has a high health pool, making you kind of tanky in team fights. This gives you a nice advantage in knowing that sometimes you can safely dive in deep and potentially make it back out. The Butcher has a trait called Fresh Meat, which means when the Butcher kills a minion or hero, Fresh Meat drops. Heroes drop 3 fresh meat and minions drop 1 fresh meat. It looks like small blood droplets. These droplets are going to be the focus of this build. Each fresh meat stacks to a maximum of 25 stacks. Each one stack provides 1% additional bonus damage, up to a maximum of 25% bonus damage. So you can see why it's important to keep these stacks up. You only lose stacks upon dying. So first of all, let's get a little sustain by selecting Victuals. Victuals makes every fresh meat you collect heal you for 3% of your maximum health. You'll find many minions dying in the crossfire of teamfights, and these ensure you stick around a little longer. Plus, it's always nice to go clear a minion wave to get fresh meat stacks and be healed at the same time. This certainly saves you often and prevents you from wasting time halving back. Okay, for your level 4 talent, I suggest Flail Axe, which is pretty basic but it really does help. Flail Axe increases the length of hamstring by 40%, giving you that extra reach to deal more damage and to just snag in that final killing blow. I personally find this the winning talent of the 4 options, but Unrelenting Pursuit is a strong talent too. This reduces the cooldown of Ruthless Onslaught by 40% on impact. It has a 20 second cooldown, so that's 8 seconds knocked off, making it a 12 second ability if the target is hit. Your level 7 talent should be Abattoir, which increases the maximum number of fresh meat from 25 to 35, and instead of losing all of your fresh meat stacks upon death, you now only lose half. This is quite valuable, as now you've increased your bonus damage by a further 10% to a maximum of 35%. So to do sufficient damage, you always want full fresh meat stacks. So if you die, this halves the time you need to refill your stacks. Now as for your ultimate, it really depends on what type of group you're in and if you can utilise some utility. But you'll usually find more success in Furnace Blast. When you trigger Furnace Blast, you have 3 seconds before fire consumes an immediate radius of the Butcher. To ensure players get caught up in this, it's best to cast Ruthless Onslaught first, then immediately cast Furnace Blast so it explodes on impact. Your level 13, I would suggest Crave Flesh. Crave Flesh increases your movement speed by 30% when an enemy is affected by Butcher's Brand. I find this really useful for keeping on top of your target, especially after casting Ruthless Onslaught and Furnace Blast together. Then when you reach the target, casting Hamstring to slow them by 40%, then keep on top of them with Butcher's Brand. Now your level 16 talent is where the Butcher will really shine. Go for Blood Frenzy. Blood Frenzy increases your attack speed by 1% for every stack of fresh meat, so this can give you a maximum of 35% increased attack speed, which works exceptionally well with Abra for Top Hat or Stimdrone for Morales. Without other hero benefits though, this talent makes the Butcher nearly unescapable after charging a hero down, and minion waves get cleared in seconds. As for your level 20, as always on a melee DPS, I suggest Nexus Blades, which increases your basic attack damage by 20% and slows enemy heroes by 20% for 1 second per hit. This will really maximise that 35% damage output you already have from your fresh meat stacks, as well as add effective damage to your 35% increased attack speed you have. With all this, I believe you're playing an effective role when selecting the Butcher. Hope this build works out fine for you and allows you to get some experience with the Butcher, and maybe let you experiment with him on your own. This has been Winrate Gaming, thank you for watching. Any questions, suggestions, or if you have any specific guides, please leave them in the comments below. Feel free to join me in live streams on Twitch, the link is in the description. If you like what you've just seen, please subscribe for more.